Hello there everybody, Digo Crash here, and today we're back with new part of Ratchet and Clank. And today we won't be heading to Nebula G34, and we will be heading towards Rilgar. Now this is actually going to be an interesting thing, because there's just a lot of things that have been replaced. We appear to be dealing with a small outbreak of amoeboids. Our security teams are working hard to rid the city of these creatures, but first they have to wake up, get washed, brush their teeth, drive over here. I mean, really, it's a whole process. So until they arrive, the race is postponed. Please stay inside your homes while we manage the crisis. Thank you. Yep, so there is actually Mark's hoverboard I want to try out. Yeah, so there is pretty much a lot of things, good lord. There's actually a lot of things that we will have to do in this run. And there's actually 4 trophies, which one of them requires backtracking, which is, you know, very interesting. No, I mean not backtracking. One of the skill points requires you to finish a certain race in another world. Oh, good lord, that was a bad idea. I should have gotten rid of that freaking shark thingy or whatever it's supposed to be, killer fish, because those killer fish are very, very dangerous, and you don't want to you don't want them to demolish you, really. Now, this is a very interesting thing. Like in this stage, we will be getting the that one gadget. I forgot what it was called. Oh, good lord! I literally forgot what was the name of that gun. Not gun, but like yeah, my memory is kind of fading out for some odd reason. Let's see if there is any killer fish. No, there isn't. So we're gonna make our way back up there. Pretty much as I was saying, we will be getting the I'm trying to remember the trespasser. There we go. Good lord, my memory is just in the fucking toilet. Good lord. Yeah, we will in this stage we will acquire the I'm not gonna waste time on this. We will acquire the trespasser, which is gonna be awesome. And we are at the right section, where I always hated this section. I really always did, where we had to actually you know, where you have to run from the water that's about to be filling up. Now actually this stage does require backtracking, since one of the golden bolts that we will be needing to get is gonna be right around that area that we just passed, which is very interesting, because it's not all too difficult, but we will need that. We will need to backtrack here once we will have the O2 mask, since it's a very important thing that we'll require in the stage. And it's gonna, you know, our process of things is gonna be a whole lot easier once we're gonna achieve all of the, once we're gonna get all of those things. Obviously, it's gonna take a lot of time. It really is going to take a lot of time, because there is a lot of weapons and a lot of gadgets that will require you to come back here in order to get everything 100%. So we will have to actually go back here once we have the O2 mask. Let's talk to this guy.
Hey pal, you got any of them Rhino holo cards?
What's a Rhino?
Only the most powerful super weapon in the galaxy, Chief. Stands for rip you a new one. See, the Gadgetron guys, they knew the plans would be too dangerous to leave in any one location. So they split them up and printed them on a bunch of holo cards. Me and my associates would very much like to acquire these holo cards, and thus the full plan.
And let me guess, if we give you all the holo cards, you'll build us the weapon.
That is correct, my industrious friend. Here, take this trespasser. It may help facilitate the acquisition of said merchandise.
Yes, and we've just got the trespasser from the guy who usually we would buy the rhino from, but apparently finding the rhino cards is an optional thing, but for 100% it is kind of required because it's one of the most important, one of the most powerful weapons in the game, that's for sure. And right now we're going to start our first thing with the trespasser. A first test.
The trespasser can short circuit powered locks. Rotate selected control ring to point detected power remaining board with remaining laser.
There you go. We've completed the first one out of all, which I think there is around 24 if I'm not wrong. And we've just got a random card. Yes, we've just got one, and this is gonna be the rhino. Yes, this is gonna be the rhino. And it's kind of easy, you know, to get that. And let's see. Yes, continue. Yes. So there's around three sets for those things, for those holo cards. And it's gonna make our life a whole lot easier because all of these collectibles are gonna be very, very easy for us. Now we're gonna be right over there. Yes, we will have to return to the ship. And obviously, like in on the PS2 version, I mean, on a PlayStation 2, you'd split into like two separate areas. Now, what do we want to do? Yeah, so we're gonna be using the Groovitron because it's one of the most useful weapons in the game. Now, here there's a trophy that you can get, which is using this gun on every single enemy that you see. So that's kind of awesome. Now let's make them dance. Wow, that's awesome. Yeah, that was beautiful. But they got me, bastards. Oh shit. Okay, let's get those bitches down. Let's demolish those bastards. And it's quite awesome. Like if you actually use this on all of the enemies, which means that you'll have to go back to Velden. You will have to use those things on the enemies on Velden all the way to pretty much the later stages to when you finish the game. Now, it's really easy to find the location of all of those. Now, here's around this area, what you want to do is you kind of want to let those guys fight those little green guys, because if you let them fight each other, if you let them exterminate 35 of those guys, 35 of those green little guys, then you'll most likely gonna get, well, you're gonna get a trophy. Now, I need to be very careful because I'm on the edge of death. I really am. So it's gonna be really scary. Now we will actually also do another. We will do a race with you know, in a race course like we did in the first games. Okay. That's good that I have health right over here because I'm really. I'm really in danger. I really am. I'm gonna let those guys actually fight, so they would actually, you know, go apeshit towards each other. Now, if there's something I want to do... I thought that there was if I remember, there was a thing that you had to unlock this area. Oh, yeah, there they are. Here are more of them. So they're gonna be fighting the next... They will be fighting each other. So technically, you will have to let those guys do the job for you and destroy those fuckers so we can actually get the trophy. So really, what you want to do is you do not want to interfere with those guys and let them do their job. And oh, wow, that was close. That was very close. I nearly died. And it's something that I really need to be careful from, because I'm really on the verge of death. So, yeah. I need to be extremely careful. And we've got a new holo card, so let's see what we've got now. Skid's Agent. Yep, we've got Skid's Agent. So... No, I'm not gonna buy Mr. Zircon. I'm not gonna buy it. Just because you want me to. We've released a whole nest of extermobots into the city. All right. We've also dispatched a few automated tanks, just to speed things along. The onboard AI doesn't let them distinguish between trespassers and locals, so it's probably best to stay indoors. Here's one of the awesome parts: is that if you get the, if you pre-order the game, you can actually unlock the bouncer, and here we are. We've got the trophy. Woohoo! Yeah, we've actually managed to get the trophy while these guys are fighting each other. Now I'm gonna make them a little dance. Dance a little. Which is very interesting. But we will have to demolish them while they are dancing around. But hopefully that's not gonna be wasting most of our ammo, because there is literally way too many enemies over here and they need to exterminate them. Alright, let's use the Groovatron on that freaking... Really? That thing is moonwalking when you do that? That's fucking retarded. But funny at the same time. It really is. Alright, so let's let the bouncer do its job and demolish those freaking bastards over there. Now, there's Raritarium around here, so it's really up there. Now, what you want to do is you need to click this thing and it's gonna get this swing shot thing right over here. So that's gonna be helping us with other adventure. And right now, oh, I'm actually full of health, as it seems. Oh yeah, I forgot that I was actually doing kind of well on that. And no, I don't want to go back. It's fucking retarded, like it takes me back instead of, oh my god. No, I don't want to use my bouncer. Fucking fagot. And here we are, up here. And we've got some Raritarium right here. And we've got some, a lot of other stuff right here, too. And I actually wanted to make it up there again, even though it's kind of impossible, since, what the fuck? There's a little glitch that, like, some of the crates are, like, really, it's like they're flashing when you're jumping next to them or something like that. It's something very odd. Really is. And now what were you wanting to... I'm just trying to actually get a lot of ammo and stuff like that in order to actually get through this area and demolish all of these bastards. Oh shit. Holy shit! And there we are. We've managed to get them all. And we're gonna go and head right... to the next area, which I bet most of you remember this from the PlayStation 2 era, and it's quite awesome to see this place, even though it looks way more awesome in compared to the PlayStation 2. It looks really way more interesting than how it was on the PlayStation 2. And what you want to do is you kind of want to lay back and see them fighting each other. Because that's one of the things. Yes, there is more of them. So you really want to let them just fight each other and stuff like that, because... wait, I'm not gonna use the protogun. And I'm gonna use this shit. Yeah, we will... this is one of the best... these two are one of the best weapons out there, and we've got a new holo card in our system, which is Angela Cross. Which I think she was introduced in one of the earlier games. And... oh shit! What the fuck? I'm like... they like cornered me. Which was fucking weird. It really was. Alright. We're gonna take those bastards down. They really are. Even though, like, they're tougher than... those enemies are way tougher than how they were in the PlayStation 2 era, which is kind of crazy. Because on the PlayStation 2, you'd hit them once and they would split, and, you know, things will go haywire, you know. Which is, you know, kind of awesome, but... I mean, this is more awesome than how the PlayStation 2 is. And especially because they improved a whole lot of on enemies and shit like that. So it's really impressive. Very, very impressive if you're asking me. Now we want to demolish those little fuggles. Alright, I will need to take care of my health because I'm on the verge of death. And there you go. We got him. Now the good part is that they actually help out, they help you out with ammo a whole lot, which is something awesome. And here we are, more ammo and more shit to go. Now, as you can see, most of these enemies will reappear and shit like that from previous points. And let's actually get back here. There's a health, what the fuck? There was health over there, so that will help us a lot. Alright. Oh lordy. Now, the as you can tell, oh, I've got another holo card? Oh my god, another holo card. Maybe it was a copy of another holo card. I'm not too sure. Everything is possible with Ratchet and Clank. And we've got more Raritarium. This is amazing. Oh, good lord. See, this is one of the most awesome weapons because you get to demolish those bastards so quickly. Even though it wastes a lot of ammo, which sucks ass, but, you know. It's something we'll have to deal with. We really will. We really need to do that. And, wow. Our weapon is actually on level 2, and our health meter actually leveled up too. It's at 50, which is amazing. Like, this is actually really awesome that it's at 50, because now this is a lot easier to deal with enemies now and compared to back then, since, you know, you just had a lot to deal with and a lot to avoid. And here we are, we took out this machine, and we're doing great, we're really doing brilliant. Wow, I was literally about to melee attack him, and that bastard got me. Alright, fuck you. Yeah, you just get that fucking in your face, bastard. Yeah, he thinks that he was a badass, but he isn't. Now, here's what you want to do. Since we all know the obvious location of the obvious location of where the golden bolt is, where you want to go is right over here. You want to jump all the right up here to this platform. There was no a sewer kind of thing. Oh good lord, I fucked up. There's no sewer type of thing that was just like how it was on a PS2. It's, you know, as you see, it's a whole, it's a little bit different, and you have to jump on this platform, and good lord, I'm doing bad. I have to jump on this platform, go all the way over there, and then go all the way to the right. And that will take you to the golden bolt, which you can see it actually kind of glowing in distance, which is awesome. Alright. Oh shit. I think I activated... I've unlocked the door of doom. Which, yeah, this is gonna be very... Yeah, this is gonna turn very nasty, if you're asking me. Very, very nasty. But this is gonna make our life a whole lot easier. And actually, this area kind of unlocks a lot of doors for us. And good lord, that fucking bastard was fucking... Lordy! Yeah, we're gonna take him out. All of them. And there you go. I don't know what are all of those things are for, but... whatever. And... Yeah, they're just following us. They're really following us, but we're gonna just forget about their existence. And we're just gonna progress through this stage and help ourselves out. And get the hell out of here.
Looks like the city is now on B-Boy 3. And we have two citizens to thank, Ratchet and Clank. The race is back on, so stay tuned for updates.
Now, let's talk to this girl.
Hey, I'm Starlene. Are you here for the race?
You know it.
Enthusiasm. I like it. All right, head inside. The first race starts in a few minutes.
Now, there's different cups. As you can see, there's bronze cup, silver cup, and gold cup. Now... You get a trophy by completing the bronze challenge, and in order to do to get another trophy is to complete the gold cup on here and on another planet too. So it will require you to finish the gold cup on both planets in order to get one trophy, which is you know, gonna save us, you know, kind of backtracking in a way, because that does not really require backtracking, but right now we're gonna be heading towards the bronze cup. Now, there is another trophy that we will do once we are very close to the end. Not very close to the end, but once we're gonna go to the gold cup. What's gonna happen? And I actually missed a golden bolt. Yeah, there's actually a golden bolt in this race. Whoa, shit. Woohee! Yes, we're looking at the next skidmark marks. Now, oh shit. Yeah, I'm kind of screwing myself over, which sucks ass, but I'm gonna be doing better. Wow. I'm kind of losing myself right here. Which is really sucks, because I was doing very well. And here we are. We've actually got the golden bolt. And voila. Here we are. Yes, you're going to see me go even faster than this. Oh shit. Woohoo! Yes, we're gonna make it to second place. Oh, good lord. I don't know why I'm not managing to do these tricks, but yeah, getting crates and doing those tricks will actually help you out a whole ton in this race. Now, you really want to... Oh, good lord. No, yes! Oh god, that was so close! Woohee!
Nice Woo. Work! You're the first Lombax to ever win a race.
Wow, that was close. Anytime.
They're always giving away cool prizes here. Perks to being sponsored by Gadgetron.
Yep. And here we are, we've got a bronze, and we just got a trophy right now. So we're gonna re-enter the race, and we're gonna go for the Silver Cup. Now, things are gonna get a whole lot more intense in compared to the first race, obviously because they added these freaking TNT boxes, which is something that you will have to be really careful from, because this is one of the things that is gonna actually screw you over in a way, which is very... Oh shit, you see? It really sucks. It really sucks, but you know, it's more, it's really challenging the way the game is. I mean, I'm not complaining. This is actually very intense, and it's very interesting too, because you kind of get to practice your skills from, you know, the previous Ratchet and Clank games, and this is quite awesome, you know. Holy shit. Yeah, well, if there is something you kind of want to do more, is you want to kind of boost a whole lot more in order to get it to gain, you know, to be in the lead, because you're most likely going to be having a difficult time on actually kind of catching up to the other characters, and it's something you really need to be taking care of, because right now I'm in... Oh shit! Oh shit! Yeah, that was bullshit. Alright, so wait, am I in the last round? Yes! No! Wow, I was literally in last round and I was doing this well. This is nuts.
You earned it.
Yeah, this was crazy. This was beyond crazy. Now, we're gonna go for the Gold Cup. I'm gonna try and do this in the most easiest way, even though I cannot guarantee anything. This is gonna be super intense in compare to the first one, to the first race. Obviously, things are placed differently, but hell yeah. So what we want to do is you need to boost up. Oh shit! If there is something you want to do, is you kind of want to boost up all the way through, and kind of catch up to everybody, and you know, gain the lead. And here we are. Woohoo! Yeah, this is kind of nuts, because those guys will be taking the lead, and it's very hard to actually kind of catch up to them. Oh good lord! Oh lordy! Yes, put your shirt back on, you bastard. Holy lord. Yeah, I'm in third place. This is kind of intense. It's not kind of intense. This is intense. Because we're in like third place and we're about to make it. Come on. I can do this. I know I can. And here we are. Wow, we are in third place. This is not good. Oh no! No! That was so close! Fuck! Oh, that was so close! Wow, I was doing good. I was actually catching up to that bastard.
And give it another try.
Yes, give it another try. Now, I've actually managed to... Wait, what? I've actually got 36... Well, 1 minute and 36 seconds. I was nearly going for the wanted time. It's just that you will have to actually do this in the most unexpected way, in a way. Now we really need to actually... Oh shit. Yeah, I'm kind of doing horribly at this right now. Even though I'm trying my best not to fuck up. Now, actually, one of the main things that you can actually get boost from is those crates. Crates with bolts, those will help you out to actually gain a lot more boost in a way. And I kind of fucked myself over. I always fuck myself over. And I really need to work on this. And I remember when I practiced this for the first time, this was super fucking crazy. I thought she said what a prick and instead of what a trick. And yes, you will be looking at the next Skid McMarks right here. I'm scared because I'm like literally on the edge of losing. Oh, wee. What you want to do is also you want to kind of stand on the top platform and do all of these. Oh shit. No, this is bullshit, no! Oh my god, yeah, we will have to fucking restart the race. This is annoying. I was doing so fucking well. I hate when it happens, and it happened to me a lot in the last time, whenever I was practicing this. I'm doing so brilliantly well, and then I fuck myself over. Which really annoys the crap out of me because I have a lot of potential in this stage. And, oh shit. Yeah, I was doing the same mistake that I was doing the first time. Alright. Oh shit. Yeah, I kind of need to boost myself over there because shit's about to get serious in this stage. Alright. Oh shit. Yeah, this is gonna be crazy! Oh shit, that was so close. I was so close to actually getting hit. Alright. Ah! Shit. Alright, come on. I can do this. This is crazy. I'm like concentrating on this. On like it's serious business or some shit. This is crazy. All right, come on, we can do this. We are, oh my God. Why am I jinxing myself? Jinkies, I really am Mr. Jinkies. Oh shit. Yes, bitch! Yes! Oh my God! Ah! Oh my God! I did it!
Wowzers, you're like amazing! You should think about going pro.
Holy shit! I've actually got the gold relic. I mean gold thing, and for finishing the gold cup, you get a holo card, and we've got the trophy right now.
We should head back to the
Holy shit! This was crazy. I literally, this was just a super intense, and I was really not ready for that. Because like this was actually very, very intense. It really was. Oh, good lord. And I literally remember when I actually practiced it for the first time. I remember struggling it. I mean, struggling with everything.
I've only seen it on my holo screen back on Velden.
Yeah, back on Velden, when you were your hometown. And right now, we're gonna be actually going towards the. We're gonna go back to our ship, and we will just unlock this area because that's gonna be helping us to actually kind of shortcut through the guy with the rhino. So what we want to do is we want to go back to the ship, and since we've got the trespasser, we are going to actually return to, we're not done with this part yet, but we're gonna return all the way back to, I think it was Novalis, if I'm not wrong, and we will actually, no, it was not Novalis, it was Kerwan. We're gonna go back to Kerwan and actually get the And we actually need to, we are going to be getting the holo card that was hiding behind the trespasser code thing. So really the trespasser, if you don't skip any of them, you will actually get a trophy for that. And all right, this took us back here. Now what we want to, what you want to do is you want to go hop onto the taxi, which is going to take us to the beginning of the stage, which is right there. I don't understand why would you need a taxi. Why isn't there a teleporter?
No problem is too big. No problem is too small.
Oh shit.
Well, some problems are too small. We have prioritized, right? So if I could catch out of my invitation on the crew one. Chances are we need to take the invasion. But otherwise, no problem is too small.
Yeah, Cork. Talk shit, don't you? Alright, so. Alright, let's actually do this puzzle. Now this is kind of a tricky one, because I always kind of fucked up on this one, which is kind of annoying. Now I'm gonna try and get that one. Alright, let's see. Holy shit! Alright. Yeah, this is gonna be really annoying since, like, this part is just really one of the most annoying ones. Wait, let's see. Well, let's go up here. And there we know we didn't. Holy shit! Alright, I'm gonna try and do this. Oh god. This is rather confusing, like I always get confused with this puzzle. Lord. Alright, let's see. Are we gonna get it? No! Oh my god, this is so annoying. No. Oh my god. It's like you need to give up on one of those in order to actually in order to get that thing out of the way. And right now we're gonna, oh my god. Yeah, you have to be very careful because that thing is gonna just destroy your entire progress, and no, this is not good. This is bad. Alright, I'm gonna be trying and doing this instead of doing that, because that should actually kind of help us out, I hope. But from what I'm seeing, it's getting really ridiculous. Alright, maybe we need to do this? No. This is gonna be really shite. Alright. Alright, let's see. No, this is not good. Oh my god! This is so annoying. This is really fucking annoying. Because I'm not managing to figure out what the fuck am I supposed to do. This is like one of the most annoying tests in the world in Ratchet and Clank history. And I remember whenever I was trying it for the first time, I was actually not doing a bad of a job. It's just that this shit is getting really annoying. And I know that if I will need to do that, then it's not gonna work. So I know I will have to keep it or that way or this way. Otherwise, like, if I were to do this, that's not gonna be working as well. Maybe I need to do this. No. I should not do this. Alright. No. And there we go, we've actually managed to make it. Good fucking lord. And here we go, we are getting another holo card pack, or more just like a holo card. That's just a holo card that we've got, and this Rhino and the Zodiac. Yeah, we've acquired the Rhino 2, so We've got the Rhino 2 out of the way, which is awesome. And we're just gonna grab some bolts, and we're gonna head back into our ship. Because we don't want to be spending too much time over here. And obviously, at a certain point, we will actually have to return to this area in order to use the Groovitron thing on all of the enemies. So that will require a lot of backtracking to do, just to get that certain trophy. Alright, so right now we're gonna be heading to our ship. And pretty much in the next part we will be heading towards Nebula G34. Wait, I don't think there's any other places that require the trespasser. If I remember correctly,
Nebula G34.
All right, so thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to drop a comment and or like and subscribe if you haven't. And we shall see you in the next part at Nebula G34. So thanks for watching, guys, and goodbye.